In the heart, there are two different cardiac cell types. There are the cardiac contractile cells and the autorhythmic cells. The cardiac contractile cells are also called myocytes. And sometimes we will call the cardiac contractile cells just contractile cells because it's just easier and it's fewer words. Or you'll hear the term myocytes. So the cardiac contractile cells make up most, or they're the majority of the cells that you will find in the heart. And they are located in the myocardium. So these are cells that are within the muscle of the heart. Their purpose is to do the mechanical work. And whenever you hear the term mechanical, you should be thinking about contraction, because mechanical means contraction of the muscle. And so here we are talking about the contraction of the heart. When the heart contracts, so here we have our contraction, that generates the force. And the force that's generated will pump the blood. And so, cardiac contractile cells are responsible for contraction of the heart. In order to do that, though, they have to create what is called the cardiac action potential. And that is what you see in this graph, the cardiac action potential. We will discuss the phases of the cardiac action potential in a separate video. For now, realize that the cardiac contractile cell's purpose in life is to contract, which generates the force to pump the blood, and in order to do that, they have to generate these cardiac action potentials. The other cardiac cell types are called autorhythmic cells, which are also called pacemaker cells. There are fewer pacemaker cells in the heart when compared to cardiac contractile cells. The autorhythmic cells are located in the conduction fibers, which make up the conduction system. And thus, you would find autorhythmic cells in the SA node, the AV node, the bundle of His, the right and left bundle branches, and the Purkinje fibers. Autorhythmic cells do not contract. They are not contractile cells, so they are not called myocytes. The purpose of the autorhythmic cells is to generate pacemaker potentials, or to generate what we call pacemaker activity. And when the pacemaker activity is generated, that will set the pace for the heart. In other words, the pacemaker cells set the heart rate. So when pacemaker cells initiate and conduct these pacemaker potentials and these pacemaker action potentials, that is going to spread through the conduction system and to the cardiac contractile cells, which we will discuss in a separate video. So for now, you need to know that the autorhythmic cells are located in the conduction system. And remember, you'll also hear them called pacemaker cells, so be sure you know both terms. Autorhythmic cells set the heart rate by generating pacemaker potentials.